Hello students, myself Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this session, we are going for the topic that is efficiency of power transmission through the pipes. The learning outcome. At the end of this session, the students will be able to derive the condition for the maximum efficiency for power transmission through the pipes. Contents. The firstly, we are going to see what is the formula of the efficiency of power transmission through the pipes. Then, the condition for the maximum power transmission through pipes. Then, the maximum efficiency of power transmission, that is, what is the value of that maximum efficiency of power transmission. And lastly, the references. Now see, in case of the power transmission through the pipes, firstly, let us have a tank and then the pipe is connected to this one and say the free surface of the liquid is there and from the center of the pipe, the free surface of the liquid, it lies at a distance of it is h, and they let the length of the pipe be equal to l, the velocity of the liquid which is passing through this pipe, let it be equal to v, and the let db equal to the diameter of the pipe through which the liquid it is flowing. Now in case of this one, the minor loss it is going to occur here where the pipe is connected to the tank it is. But we are going to not consider in case of power derivation, and here we are going to have say neglecting minor losses. So neglecting minor losses, we will have the efficiency of power transmission, this is equal to. So this is going to be, so power at outlet of pipe divided by, so it is power at, it is inlet of pipe. See what we are having, we are having the outlet of the pipe, the power there it is to be considered, we are having the inlet of the pipe and the power there it needs to be considered, and the ratio of these two we are having. Now as you are knowing the power, it is having the units as equal to it is watts. So in case of that one, watt means again it is joules per second, and then it is newton meter, then it is per second. So here in case of this, we can see that newton per second, this is nothing but it is the weight of liquid which is flowing per unit time, and this one it is nothing but it is head. So we can write it as, say here it is weight of liquid say per second multiplied by head at inlet of pipe and divided by, it is weight of liquid per second multiplied by head at outlet of pipe. Now let us put the values and the cancellation part also we are going to carry out. Say weight of liquid per second, weight of liquid per second, it is cancelled now. And now head at out inlet of, head at it is outlet of the pipe, and here it is head at the inlet of the pipe we are having. So outlet, outlet, inlet and inlet it is. Now in case of this, let this be say capital H. We are going to have the losses corresponding to this, it is minor loss and the frictional loss it is going to occur here. But minor loss we are not considering. So from here to here, the frictional loss or the major loss it is going to occur. So if the inlet of the pipe is there at that time, let this be capital H. Capital H is the head available, and at outlet we can observe that the frictional head loss is going, say, taking place now because of that one. So at outlet the value will be lesser by the losses which are occurring. So now here it is going to be H minus, it is HF divided by, it is going to be H. So this is the formula of the efficiency of the power transmission through the pipes. So H, it is going to be the head at the inlet of the pipe, HF, it is going to be the loss, and then again this H, it is appearing. So this is the efficiency of power transmission. Now let us see what is the condition for maximum power transmission. So condition for maximum power transmission we are interested in is, firstly, say power transmission is equal to, so power we are going to have this as, since it is rho g q, and say it is H minus HF we are having. So this much is the power which has been transmitted, and we are interested in the maximum value of this one, and in case of this, let this be indicated by letter P. So power P, and then it is rho g, and then say let this Q be, it is equal to A into V. So it is now pi by 4, then it is d square, that is the cross section area of the pipe. Let V be the velocity, and then it is H, and then minus, it is HF, let us write it in terms of the velocity, it is 4FL V square by it is 2GD. Now see, we are going to have this one as V, we will take inside, say it is rho G into it is pi by 4, then it is D square, we will keep it here only, and V into it is H minus 4FL, it is V cube divided by it is 2GD we are having. So this one was P. Now what we will do is, we will go for now, say differentiating with reference to V and equating to 0 for power maximum. So it is now dP by dV is equal to, so here it is d by dV of, it is rho g pi by 4 into it is d square into bracket it is HV minus it is 4FL V cube divided by 2GD. Say this one it is into the whole rectangular bracket, but and this is to be equated to 0. Then let us take this constant term outside, say it is now rho g pi by 4 and then it is d square, and the function of V is only, say the inner part it is HV minus 4FL, it is V cube divided by it is 2GD, and this one is equal to 0. So now as we are having this as one parameter and this one as another parameter, as multiplication of these two is equal to 0, but as rho g pi by 4 d square cannot be equal to 0, we are going to have d by dv of HV minus 4FL V square by 2GD as equal to 0. Then taking the differentiation, so here d by dv of HV, so it is going to be H minus then this 4FL, then d by dv of it is actually V square, otherwise the other terms, these are constants, so it is 2GD also constant. So it is d by dv of, it is now V cube. So 4FL V cube by 2GD is there, it is 4FL V cube by 2GD. So d by dv of, it is V cube, and then this one is equal to 0. So here it is H minus, it is 4FL divided by it is 2GD. So this one, it is 3, it is V square, and then this one is equal to 0. So in case of this one, we are now having this as, it is 4FL V square divided by it is 2GD. So except the 3, we are having this one as equal to HF. So it is H minus HF into 3 is equal to 0. So what it indicates? It indicates that HF should be equal to, let us take this to the right side and again 3 will be divided. So it is HF is equal to, it is H by 3. So this is what we are getting, the condition, that is the frictional head loss should be equal to the 1/3 of the total head which is available at the inlet of the pipe. Next to that one, the maximum efficiency we can go for. So it is maximum is equal to, so it is, now we are having this as H minus HF divided by, it is capital H, and let us put the value of this one. So it is H minus, then it is H by 3, then we are going to have this as H, then it is going to be 2 by 3. So lastly, which comes out to be 0. Say it is 667, etc. So the maximum efficiency which we are getting is equal to, say it is 0.67. So that is what we are confined to, the maximum efficiency which we are getting. So above this one, the efficiency, it is not possible in case of this. So totally, firstly you can have the revision. So it is, the efficiency is equal to, it is H minus HF divided by, it is H, and then the condition for the maximum efficiency, it is HF is equal to, it is 1/3 of the head at the inlet, and lastly the maximum efficiency is equal to, it is 0.67, that is 2/3 it is. So we are having the restriction on the maximum efficiency of the power transmission. See, these are the references. Thank you.